Lights, camera, action!
There's an Instagram meme that says, "Don't work 8 hours for a company and then go home and not work on your own goals. You're not tired. You're uninspired." Fam, I'm here to tell you, I am tired and uninspired. So I've been in a rut lately. Y'all know that tends to happen. But yeah, you know, I've been in a creative rut, a social rut, a physical rut, and a mental rut. So it's like hit me all directions, hitting me in all, you know, all parts. But things are improving. I am climbing out of this rut. You know, as far as socially, I hung out in Hollywood recently. Creatively, I really haven't done any writing since I finished working on Jungle Fortune and Azalea, the Jungle Fortune script and the Azalea treatment. But I did come up with a new idea. It's just an idea, you know. I had a spark of inspiration and I was like, okay, this is something that I kind of want to plot out. So I've got that in the back of my mind. But since Azalea is definitely the next script that I have to write, I'm gonna get into that. I've also been doing a lot better as far as like eating healthy meals, staying consistent with my diet. I've lost about 6 pounds, and it's really just been from eating a lot better, totally cutting back on fast food, eating less processed foods and more whole foods. And the thing that's really just kind of helped me, which I never thought about this stuff or like looked into it, but I really started like counting calories. Like I started weighing my portions and counting calories and all this stuff. And what I've come to realize is that, and this is going to sound obvious to a lot of you, I know, but again, this is just shit that I just never thought about, but it's possible to eat hella food if they are low in calories. So you can remain like satiated, you won't feel hungry, and it's healthy. So yeah, you know, I've been doing that, so we'll see. The gym, I've been on and off with the gym, and I need to be a lot more consistent because I'm trying to get swole on y'all. So we're coming up on the beginning of a new month. I watched a video recently that talked about how, you know, we get motivated, we get excited or whatever in order to start achieving our goals. But the best time to do that, I mean, you know, the best time to do it is now or whatever bullshit they say. But really the best way to do it is to kind of tie your start date to a date that has meaning. You know, I was told things like birthdays, not necessarily holidays, but things maybe like the first day of spring or the first day of summer, like whatever. But if you can tie your start date to a date on the calendar, like a meaningful date on the calendar, for whatever reason, that kind of helps you stay motivated. Not stay motivated, but it does something to you where it's just like it's easier to kind of chug along and be consistent. I don't know why. I guess there's some science behind it, but I don't know why. But whatever, that's not my field of expertise. I just decided, hey, you know, August 1st is coming up and seems like a good time to really hunker down and try to focus and do what I need to do. And that's from everything from like, you know, the physical aspect, you know, like just continuing to eat healthy, but also get back in the gym, but also with my writing, you know, I can I've already got the treatment for Azalea written. Let's just jump into writing that first draft and just remaining consistent, trying to ignore and block out all of the bad, the negative, the distractions, whatever. So that's what I'm going for. Who knows if I'll be successful, but I'm gonna try, because, you know, gotta figure some shit out, because falling into these ruts, they're not good. They're not good, and even though I'm always able to get out of them, I just don't like this shit. And so I need to figure out a way to prevent myself from falling into a rut. I also just want to give y'all, like, I don't know, just quick life updates. I know some of you have been, like, leaving comments. I see the comments. I really do appreciate y'all. Thank you. I apologize for not always responding to comments. Sometimes I'll see a comment that deserves, like, a thoughtful answer, not just a few emojis, you know, laughing emojis or thumbs up. And I want to craft, like, a thoughtful answer, but then time gets away from me, or I'm just tired and uninspired, so it's just like I can't answer your comment right away. But I do see them. I thank you for leaving them. It means a lot that y'all comment and share with me your feelings, what you're going through, what you think about whatever the topic of the video is. And I do feel that, you know, we connect in that way. So thanks a lot. Thank you. But to address some of the things that people have asked me, let's start with, I've actually had some people comment and say, Jay, you should stop harassing your neighbors, you know, your downstairs neighbors or whatever. And it's just like, I'm not harassing those folks at all. At all. I mentioned the grandfather, like, banging on the ceiling, which is my floor, and having the conversation with him and his son. And since then, there's been no banging. I see all of them on occasion, and we all speak. We're all very civil to each other. You know, the little girl is just like, hey, hi, how are you? And you know what? She hasn't been, like, annoyingly loud. I don't know if, I mean, clearly they're at home, but, you know, like, the singing Alicia Keys at the top of her lungs, that has stopped. The random woo-wooing and other screaming, that has stopped. That's pretty much all I was asking for. As I've always said, we all live in this building. We all have to live together, and what we all do affects everyone else. And knowing that I was probably up here making noise that was disturbing the grandfather while he's trying to sleep. Like I said, like, you know, don't run my dishwasher at night. I actually try to walk quietly. I'm aware of, like, certain areas that kind of creak or whatever, and I try my best not to walk on those areas, or if I do, to tread lightly. You don't want to walk on eggshells in your own apartment, but at the same time, and as far as Sir Rap-A-Lot next door, don't, you know, they haven't been blasting music, they haven't been, you know, causing any ruckus or anything like that. I think it's because, for the most part, like, they've had to get day jobs, they have to leave the apartment for long, you know, segments of the day, so it's just like, all right, cool. Don't get it confused, I still very much hate living here, coming up on my 2-year anniversary, being out here, and I fucking hate it. August makes 2 years for me in this complex, in this area. This is my second apartment in this apartment complex. The first one I moved to was lower level. I had upstairs neighbors that were a fucking nightmare. I was only there for, I guess it was 4 months, 5 months, August, September, October, November, December. So 5 months. And then this unit opened up. And so I moved to this upstairs unit and was super excited and very happy until I discovered that I lived next door to an aspiring rapper who treated his apartment like a recording studio. And then several months later, I think it was like August, actually, these people moved in and more noise. But as I also said earlier, things have calmed down considerably. Hasn't been as much of, like, the loud, loud noise. So all that is, like, super cool. But yeah, 2 years. And I'm fucking sick of it. I'm done. I'm done. I want to be done. I promise I'm going to go into much greater detail about this in a later video. I'm planning it, so I want to bring y'all on this journey. But I did finish Jungle Fortune. Very proud of it. When I say finish, I mean finish the rewrite, because this was one of the scripts that I brought out to Los Angeles when I moved from New York. But I wanted to do a rewrite just to kind of freshen it up, add some new details. You know, I've learned a lot in the 4 years that I've been out here, so I wanted to apply what I've learned to what I've already done. So I did that. I did that. I was also told to come up with something personal, which is what Azalea is. So I wrote the treatment, gonna jump right into that, hopefully get like a vomit draft done in August. Like, that is my goal, is just to, whether it's good, whether it's bad, just to hammer out that first draft in the month of August and then go back and rewrite and refine before I decide to send out. In addition to all that, I'm trying to think of a new strategy to get stuff out. You know, before I've kind of like poo-pooed the notion of contests and everything like that, but I think I'm gonna, you know, take a look at, you know, what contests are out there, take a look at what kind of like fellowships and mentorships and like all those other opportunities. I'm gonna see what I think would be a good fit for me. I do appreciate everybody who's been throwing stuff my way. I haven't really applied to a lot of them simply because a lot of the requirements I don't meet. For instance, someone sent me, it was like, I don't know, some writing fellowship, and I'm just like, yo, this looks really good. And even though it was more geared toward television, they would accept feature scripts from applicants. Now it's just like, oh, this is great. Yeah, that's, you know, right up my alley. But they were only accepting submissions from people who already had films made and were accepted into film festivals. I was just like, well, okay. I mean, that's certainly one way to cut the number of entries. You know specifically what you're looking for, but I don't have a film, a short or a feature already completed that has been submitted to and accepted by a film festival. I'm just like, that's a very specific requirement for a program that's trying to help people break in. I'm just like, oh, I get it, you know. It seems like festival acceptance has already, well, whatever. But I get it, I get it. So it's just like stuff like that. Like, that's why I haven't really taken advantage of like any of these opportunities, because some of the requirements I just don't meet. I just, you know, or I haven't, I did not meet at the time. I'm also going to try to work on like the guest list TV pilot. I've gotten some really encouraging feedback on the pilot. Now, if you guys remember when I sent the guest list pilot off to We Screenplay for coverage, it got good notes, but it was still, you know, like they were just like pass and, you know, like, you know, whatever, whatever. But when I've let, and I'm going to say it like this, when I've let like people who are in the industry, working writers, when I've let them read it, they've all just been like, this is great. This is, you know, you could probably do this or do that. You know, they've given me notes, but they've said that it's quality work. So I'm gonna, you know, try to work on that a little more and see if that can work as a submission for some of these opportunities that that are more geared toward TV. Even though I'm not a TV guy, you know, I'm features. Like, I am 100% features. That's my focus. If writing for TV can be a path toward feature writing, then shit, why not, right? You know, explore all opportunities. So I'm gonna work on the guest list pilot and see what I can do with that, where I can send that. Who knows? And yeah, as I said, like there's a lot that's been happening, and I do want to share that with y'all, but I'm going to create a dedicated video talking about that, discussing that. I'm gonna make some videos discussing a lot of my experiences. Like, there's really been a lot that I haven't shared with y'all, and part of it is, you know, the industry is small, and I don't want to say shit that, you know, might mess up my chances. But at the end of the day, my goal is to bring you on this journey and to be honest with y'all, to let y'all know exactly what it is that I've seen, experienced, gone through. Maybe it will be helpful for some of you. So after finishing this video, I happened to cross another Instagram quote, and I thought it funny because it's pretty relevant to what I was saying earlier. And that quote is, "You are not lazy, unmotivated, or stuck. After years of living your life in survival mode, you are exhausted. There's a difference." Release your mind, release your job, release the time, release the strain, release the stress, release the love, forget the rest. I'm gonna lay down my head, cause I lost my mind. V is back and I'm sleeping real good at night. The queens in the front and the doms in the back. Ain't taking no flicks, but the whole click snap. There's a whole lot of people in the house trying to smoke with the yak in your mouth. And we back outside. You said you outside, but you ain't that outside.